Rev up your engines. Today I'm going to talk about the new bad change that's occurring in modern car air conditioning systems. By law in the United States, they're changing the refrigerant from 134A to R1234YF, a new type of refrigerant. Now years ago, the change was made from R12, which was called Freon, to R134A. And that was a big enough pain. Now it's all based on laws to not deplete the ozone layer. The 134A is less ozone depleting than the R12, and this new one is much less ozone depleting. But if you ask me, the tiny amount of refrigerant that's in cars that sometimes leaks out isn't that big of a deal, really, when you consider how much gasoline we burn and pollute atmosphere with that stuff. This whole changing refrigerant scene that they've been doing lately, hey, it's kind of like closing the barn door after the horses have already ran away. Now, the first thing with this new refrigerant is cost. Here's a 134A canister. It's 30 pounds and it cost me about $95 last year. And here's a 10 pound container of the new R1234YF. It costs $1,000 for 10 pounds, so that would be $3,000 for 30 pounds. So right away you can see, they're ripping everybody off. They're charging $3,000 for something that I used to pay $90 for, and there's no way it costs that kind of money to make this stuff. That's just total nonsense. And not only are you paying a lot more for the refrigerant, hey, as a mechanic, I have to go out and buy a new recycling machine because by law, I have to use a recycling machine for each type of refrigerant. Now, I already have one for the 134A, but to work on the new R1234YF refrigerant system, I gotta buy another machine. So as you can already guess, having these new AC systems worked on is gonna cost you a whole lot more money. But perhaps the worst aspect of this new R1234YF refrigerant is this. The old 134A, it's virtually inflammable. It's not going to start on fire if you get in a wreck and it leaks out, or if it has a leak in the dash and gets inside and you're smoking a cigarette. It's pretty much non-flammable under any condition you're going to meet in a car. But this new R1234YF refrigerant, it's actually flammable. Now you would think the scientists, with all their intelligence, could come up with a better system than replacing a non-flammable gas with a flammable gas in cars that people drive. Let's say you get in a wreck, the AC system starts gassing out. That could start on fire. Or if it starts leaking inside the evaporator, that could start a fire inside your car, especially if you're a smoker. This flammability is such a big deal to some manufacturers. Listen to this. German manufacturers Daimler, Volkswagen, and others don't want to use R1234YF in their vehicles, but will do so for the near future to meet U.S. refrigerant regulatory actions. They tested them in cars, said when their compressor ruptured, they could start fires inside the engine, and they found something even worse. That burning R1234YF emits toxic hydrogen fluoride gas. You really don't want to be breathing that stuff in if something happens. Instead, the Germans are working on something called R744, which is CO2, carbon dioxide. Now, of course, we breathe out carbon dioxide, so it's not flammable. It's a very cheap gas, but in itself, it has a big problem. R134A and the new R1234YF, they have the highest operating pressure and a high point of 300 to 400 PSI. But the carbon dioxide system, it can operate at 1400 PSI. So there's a lot more pressure. And guess what? The higher the pressure, you gotta build them stronger. They have to be made better. They cost a lot more to make. And with that extra pressure, of course they're gonna break faster. And of course that much pressure in itself can be dangerous. If you've got 1400 PSI pressure in your dash and it blows up, it could send shrapnel all over the place. So of course, now they're working on even more complex systems where the CO2 system is all under the hood of the car, and then there's another cooling system that takes the cool air from that system under the hood and moves it inside the dash. I mean, these things are getting more and more insanely complex for a system that worked fine in the first place. But as it stands now, here's a list of cars that presently use it, from BMW, Cadillac, Chrysler, all the way down to Toyota. But as I see it, hey, why are they switching from a gas that works perfectly fine, is non-flammable, and switching it to a flammable gas? To me, it just does not
make sense.
Do they really need to charge $3,000 for a can of something that used to cost me $90? Holding people hostage that want to be cool in their cars? That's just not right. But of course, it gives you even more reasons to hang on to your old car. That's a 94 Celica. It came with R134A. It still blows really cold. Got the original compressor on it. But at least now you know what's going on with this new refrigerant. And you can make an intelligent choice. Maybe even complain to some of your legislature about it, and they might end up giving up with this stuff. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.